basketball. You're not supposed to slam dunk a piano.
I've got to learn how to play this dumb thing so I can accompany Nell and Daddy at the charity show.
If you believe in charity, don't play.
But it's for the veterans of foreign wars.
If you believe in peace, don't play.
I just finished working out my jazz routine. See what you think of it, okay?
No, Katie, Katie, I'm
come on, please.
I'm not very
good at this. Come on, you guys. Come on.
Fine.
Good.
Okay.
Doing downstairs in your underwear.
Dad, this is the outfit I'm wearing for your VFW charity show.
When I had pants like that, they had a trap door. Licorice drops. Leave some for me this time, will you? What a day. Since 8 this morning, I've had 4 auto thefts, 3 assaults. Some bunko artist is cleaning up with a door-to-door scam. Half an hour ago, 3 guys held up the 7-Eleven and stole a Donkey Kong. I'm gonna fix myself some iced coffee. And if you think you're wearing that to the VFW, you're VFW. Very far wrong.
Afternoon, Dad.
Ah.
Oh, what fun we're going to have. Chuckles is home. Yes? Well, hello down there.
Hi.
What can I do for you?
I'm collecting for Jerry's kids.
Oh, girls, come in. I think I'm in love.
Oh, isn't he adorable?
Anything you can give. A dime, a quarter, anything.
I'll get my purse out the kitchen. Hey. Did anyone ever tell you that you have Carol Channing's hairdo?
Here you go, kitty.
Here, this is all
I can find. Sorry, I wish it could be more.
Just wait till you see this angel, chief. Take a look at that kitty.
Yeah, I see him. Kid, aren't you a little young to be out collecting money by yourself? Couldn't you leave me at least one licorice drop? Where do you live?
On the other side of town.
Honey, you walked all the way over here from the other side of town by yourself?
Yes, ma'am. You see...
Oh, what? Hey, come on, sit down. What is it, honey?
No, it's nothing.
You can tell your Aunt Nell.
My little 3-year-old brother?
Mm-hmm.
He's really one of Jerry's kids.
Oh.
And it's like I'm collecting for him.
Oh, yeah, and I was only gonna give you a dollar. Here, baby, make it 5, okay?
He's really sick.
Okay. Make it 10.
Gee, thanks.
Oh. Here's a 10. Just so you know, the police chief isn't cheap.
I gotta go.
Hey, what's your hurry?
Hey.
My kid brother's waiting for me. And I want to be there if he suddenly, you know.
Oh. Oh. I know. Oh, my God, that poor kid.
You know, Chief, this just makes you realize how lucky we are, you know?
Look, everybody, I'm sorry if I was a little rough on you when I came home.
Okay, Dad. I love you, Kane.
I love you, too.
I love you, Nell.
Look, I'm going to get rid of whoever that is at the door so we can go back to loving each other.
I caught the bunco artist, Chief. He's been using some phony story about Jerry's kids. You dirty crook.
Come on, this run?
I don't believe that.
Honest, the kid's a real pro. You know how many jerks in this neighborhood are giving him a lot of money?
Give me a break. Now I know what it takes. I'm putting a new face on the old one. Ready for anything. Playing with fate. Not a moment too late. Showing the whole world.
You won't be doing it for the VFW. You'll be doing it for the Odd Fellows.
This is what I do. You want me to do it? Then this is what I do.
Daddy, you're not good.
The best you can hope for is some weird cult following. I'm going upstairs and study.
Studying sounds like fun.
You see that? I'm so bad, I'm driving my daughters to homework. I'm not doing the show.
You're backing out? All right. If you're backing out, then I'm backing out, too. Let's forget the whole thing. Let's forget it's for the underprivileged children. I'm coming! Let's just forget it. Forget the whole thing. Forget it's for these little kids who don't have any food to eat. No clothes to wear, no toys to play. We just forget the whole thing.
Right, let's forget it.
You old softy, you. I'm coming! What, Simpson?
Yeah, hi, you Nell. Come on, kid.
What are you doing here with the kid? You were supposed to turn him into the county juvenile office.
What? The county juvenile officer, Mrs. Grossman, is going to be delayed a few hours. She'll pick the kid up here.
Hey, it's Jerry's kid.
Yeah, what are we going to do with him?
Well, you can't leave him locked up with hardened criminals. Come here, kid. How old are you?
6 3/4.
Here's his personal belongings, Chief. One jackknife, Swiss. 3 marbles, German, and a whole pocket full of licorice drops. I don't know where they came from.
I do.
You know the chief is brilliant. He could take one look at licorice drops and right away tell you exactly what country they came from.
Simpson?
Huh?
Is there anything else?
247 dollars in cash.
$247? Are you single, kid?
What's your name, kid?
He wouldn't tell me either.
You can't get the name out of a 6-year-old? What kind of cop are you?
Average. I don't know why he wouldn't tell me his name. I told him mine right away.
Well, look who's back.
I guess his lawyer must have sprung him.
No, he's just going to be here till the social worker picks him up. Hey, kid, now tell me your name. You can tell your Aunt Nell.
You're my aunt. You know my name.
Look, kid, I'm the chief of police. This is serious business. Now, what's your name?
Luke Skywalker.
Now we're getting someplace. What's so funny?
Oh, Daddy, he gave you a phony name.
Now, you listen to me, you little punk. I want your real name, and I want it now, or I'll beat it out of you. Maybe I should try a different tack.
Chief, I think I understand this kid. I'll get it out of him. Let's go in the kitchen. Get in here! Stay out of this! Get in here! Get in here! Just stay out of this! What does it take to bribe you?
Got any ice cream? Vanilla? I need a spoon. Joey.
Joey what?
Got any chocolate syrup? Joey Donovan.
Hello, Joey Donovan. I'm Nell Hopper.
Hi, Aunt Nell.
Aunt Nell. Well, Joey Donovan, are you going to tell your Aunt Nell everything about yourself?
Got any pecans?
How can a little kid like that be so cute and still be so tough?
He reminds me of me when I was a kid. I was adorable.
Hey, that must be where you get your looks, Katie.
Your legs, too.
Well, I told you I could handle him. All it took was a little love and a lot of ice cream.
What did you find out?
Well, his name is Joey Donovan. He's an orphan, and he's been traveling around with his uncle, a con man named Jerry.
Jerry's kid.
Anyway, Jerry left him stranded here in town.
Louse.
Chief, he didn't want to talk about it, but he started this door-to-door thing to get up enough money to go find this uncle.
Oh, yes. Hello, bus station? I'm sending my 6 3/4-year-old son to Chicago. How much would that ticket be, please?
Wow, that much?
You got all that out of him? Nell, you're sensational.
I am, aren't I? You know, Chief, I don't want to try to tell you how to run your job, but I'm an expert. You know, you just have to be open with kids and honest, you know? Which is a good way to get your purse stolen.
Hi, Aunt Nell.
they throw the book at you. Somebody give me a book.
Can I go to the kitchen?
No, sit down and be quiet.
But I just want a glass of water.
You heard the chief. No water.
A crust of bread?
I'll get it for him.
No, you don't. Can't you see what the kid's doing? He's playing on your sympathy.
He's got mine.
He's only 7 years old.
6 3/4.
Hey, chief, why don't you call the social worker?
That's it.
That's what?
That's why I was coming back towards here. I got a call on the radio. Mrs. Grossman, the social worker, can't make it.
Why not?
She's got the measles.
Kidding.
Mrs. Grossman is very susceptible to childhood diseases. Last year, she had the mumps. The year before that, it was the whooping cough. And the year before
Simpson?
Can I have a piece of your licorice, Chief?
No.
Can I have a piece, Chief?
No.
Chief, please give him a piece of your licorice.
All right.
You can have a piece of the licorice.
Thanks, Nell.
Get out of here, Simpson!
Hey, I just thought of something. I've been around this kid a lot. Joey, have you ever had the mumps?
Not yet.
Mumps can make an adult person sterile. Not that it makes any difference.
I'm gonna call Judge Harrison at juvenile court.
Can I go to the bathroom?
No.
But I gotta go.
You heard the chief.
No.
Judge Harrison, this is Chief Ganisky. I'm sorry to bother you at home, but I have a homeless juvenile here, and Mrs. Grossman is sick. You know, this time it's the measles.
I knew a kid that wouldn't let go to the bathroom, and he blew up like a balloon.
Okay, go upstairs and make it quick.
All right, Your Honor, I'll take care of it. Where's he going?
To let some air out of his balloon.
What did the judge say, Dad?
I'm responsible for that kid until Monday morning.
He's staying here all weekend?
Yeah, until the new social worker shows up.
Great, he can take over my room.
I think it'll be fun.
Yeah, we'll take him to the movies.
He's not leaving this house.
Chief, maybe you're forgetting that he is just a little boy.
And maybe you're forgetting that he stole your purse, my licorice, the money. The money, it's gone! And you wanted to give him licorice. Samantha, get that kid down here.
You're not gonna be rough on him, Dad.
Yeah, Daddy, remember the law. He's innocent until proven guilty.
Maybe he didn't steal the money, Chief. It could have accidentally got stuck to the bottom of the licorice.
And he ate $247?
He's not in the bathroom.
What?
He can't have gotten far. Well, somebody get rid of these towels hanging from the... Nell, this is all your fault.
My fault?
Yeah, you're the one who said we should have guest towels in the bathroom. Look, you people, not a word about this to anyone. If Judge Harrison hears that the police chief can't hold a 6-year-old kid in this house, I'll be pounding a beat with Simpson. And I hate Simpson.
Hey, I got an idea. You stay here by the phone.
What?
Listen, contrary to what your father says, Joey did not lie. He did say, I gotta go. And when you gotta go, you gotta go.
Trails West Bus 49. Buckstar, the Santa Rodeo. Now boarding at 8 a.m. San Francisco arrival at gate 7.
All right, Joey. Coming with me.
My name's Sydney.
Oh, I'm sorry. You see, I have a friend who has a jacket like that.
Some kid trained me this jacket for my cowboy hat.
A cowboy hat? Thank you, honey. Go play.
Oh,
right, cowboy. It's time for the last roundup.
My name's Sydney.
Sydney, come here. Give me this jacket, huh? Here's your hat. Go find your mama. All right, mister, just where do you think you're going?
Chicago to see my uncle.
Billy Martin Baseball Camp.
Bus drivers are nice for kids. If they think they're going to camp.
Okay, but why did you pick Billy Martin?
He's my idol.
That's perfect. Honey, you don't even know where your uncle is in Chicago.
I'll find him. Huh. I guess you'd think I'm dumb to want to be with my uncle.
No, I don't think you're dumb to want to be with your uncle. Everybody needs somebody.
She don't need you.
Well, 3 days with you ain't exactly happy days in Dixieland either.
You don't have to get mad.
Well, I don't want to get mad. I want to help you, but you won't let me. I tried to be nice to you, and you stole my purse. You took 200... Give me that money. Get up. That money.
This lady's trying to rob me.
Get out of my face. Let's go home. Get down.
I'll screen up all everybody who kidnapped me.
Go right ahead. I work for the chief of police, and just who do you think they're gonna call, huh?
Go ahead. Put the cuffs on out. Me. Put me
one. Let's go, Joey.
No.
Get off the floor. What'd you say?
Aunt Nell.
What?
You don't get mad.
Joey, Aunt Nell won't get mad. Aunt Nell promises.
Before we leave, can I go to the bathroom?
Okay, but hurry back. The bathroom. Do with this kid.
Next week on Give Me a Break.
Be a good boy. Eat your chicken.
No.
Please.
I'm on a hunger strike, and I'm not going to an orphanage.
But honey, you haven't eaten all weekend. Come on, take one teeny weeny bite. Come on, take a bite for Nell. Aunt Nell, take... You bit me, and you drew blood, you little vampire.